way to welcome in a new day as we hit the midway point of our Danube Delta Discovery Tour with Scenic. The sun deck is prime position for today's cruising.
What is it about this part of the world that you love?
It just seems so different from everywhere else I've been. I've been really lucky and I've been able to travel the world quite a bit with my work. But to actually get to this part of the world has been fantastic.
Meeting friends and sharing these experiences makes it all the more memorable.
I was very envious when I discovered that you were travelling together. Tell me, how's it been?
Absolutely fabulous. I never thought that I would do it, and it's been terrific, really terrific, really enjoyed it.
Yeah, it's been fabulous to be able to experience this with my mum and all the beautiful places we've got to visit, and we've just had such a great time.
Dining on board is one of the highlights of the trip, with the main restaurant downstairs and Portobello's up here for a fine dining experience. Each night you'll be entertained with the onboard musician or local performers. Tonight, though, we've planned our own little surprise.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Because you've become a moon orbiting around my heart. Stars and satellites won't keep us apart.
Our luxury home on the water, the Scenic Jewel, has brought us to our final destination, Romania.
The mighty Danube stretches over 2,800 kilometres across the continent, and this is where it spills into the Black Sea and meets the coast. Near the river's mouth is a largely unspoilt wetland area, home to remote villages like St. George and several hundred species of birds.
Danube Delta and this area is very important for birds. It's the entire area is declared biosphere reserve.
And is there any reason why specifically this land is so good for those birds?
The Danube itself is carrying a lot of sediments, and the soil is very rich. That's why here in the Delta you find the biggest surface of reed beds, and it's a very good site for colonies of cormorants, pelicans as well. They are nesting in the reeds.
The town has just 700 permanent residents, and the only industries are fishing and farming.
So this is a typical traditional house here, is this right?
Yeah, we are in a very remote area here, St. George called village, and this kind of houses have this architecture of Russian Lipovans, which Russian Lipovans made it. The walls are made of clay and wood and reeds. And the roof, it's covered in reeds, which is ecological. It's thermal insulate.
Oh, handmade.
Yeah, handmade.